And he's in the building right now.
Yes, sir.
Deuces, number one on urban charts for 10 weeks.
Thanks, man.
No BS, number one for 2 weeks. And look at me now, is in the top five.
Yeah, man. We getting it.
Now, I've heard that you've already moved past fame to fortune.
Kind of, sort of. I think with my album, I wanted to kind of deliver a double CD. I wanted to do like 25, 30 songs just so people can just hear my music. But you know, with labels and complications with that, they want to make sure that they market and do everything right. So they're not going to allow you to do all those CDs like they used to in the back in the day. So I was like, okay, cool. Well, this is a deal. If I do this Fame album right now, it has to have two parts to it. So you hear this, and by this time, I'm just praying that all my singles, you know, will carry on for the next six to 8 months, and you'll hear all the songs that I have. And then 6 months from now, come on with the Fortune edition of this album. Yellow model chick, yellow bottle sipping, yellow Lamborghini, yellow top missing. Yeah, yeah, that shit look like a toupee. I get what you get in 10 years, in 2 days.
Chris Brown, Riding High, brand new CD out, Fame, it's out today, already has 3 number one hits, a fourth one climbing the charts, and the album is number one on iTunes today. It's a far cry from the last time the two of us sat down, just months after he pled guilty to felony assault. He took responsibility for hitting his then-girlfriend, Rihanna, and has spent the last 2 years rebuilding his life and career. My hair has grown a great deal since the last time I saw you two. Chris Brown, how are you?
I'm pretty good, yeah. Everything's good, yeah.
And thank you for sitting down for just a moment before. It's all about the music. Your fans are here, but you have been very about talking with me a little bit about this, because we've gone through it and talked about it when I went to your home. You can go to events and be in the same room. Have you all seen each other, been around each other?
I mean, not really. I mean, it's not really a big deal to me now as far as that situation. Mm-hmm. I think I'm past that in my life, and I think today is the album day, so that's what I'm focused on. So everybody go get that album.
And that is something that we are here to talk about, but thank you very much
for
willing to do that. Fame. F-A-M-E.
Yeah.
What does that stand for?
Fame. Forgiving all my enemies, and definitely fans are my everything, and that meaning, like, you know, being able to go through everything I went through and show my fans that I love them, you know? That's what it is, and fans are my everything.
When you say forgive all your enemies, who do you consider your enemies?
Just anybody, naysayers, haters, whatever the case may be. I just think, you know, being positive and promoting that is what I'm about now, and that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah, but you can understand how some people, you know, that was very serious, what you went through and what happened, and even the judge, though, afterwards said that you had served your time as far as the community service and that and move it on. But have you been able to? How have you been able to?
I've been focusing on this album, you know. I think this album is what, you know, I want people to hear and want people to really get into. So definitely this album is what I want them to talk about and not the stuff that happened 2 years ago.
I understand that.
So the year is 2010. And at this point, Chris Brown was damn near going through hella shit the year prior to this. The whole Rihanna incident and shit took a toll on people and shit. It just made the whole industry / people turn on this man, bro. So Chris Brown took it upon himself to just say, man, fuck y'all niggas. I'ma keep doing what I'm doing. And this nigga will start just releasing, flooding the market with hella mixtapes and shit. Make a collab project with Tyga. And just start to flood in the market with fire ass songs / tapes and shit. Cause at this point, bro, Chris Brown wasn't the same baby faced little kid that we all met and started to know from 2005 when he first came out to damn near exclusive shit. He wasn't that baby faced teen ass nigga no more. This nigga damn near was tatted up and shit. This nigga had hella shit going on already and shit. This nigga started smoking and shit. He was getting older, so he wasn't that teen no more and shit. So it was only right for him to already switch up the sound of his music, because we all know that clean boy image is thrown out the window, definitely after the Rihanna shit. It just it was time for him to finally start to make that change into his music. And that's when he started leaning more into the hip-hop scene and started making more songs and shit. So more people from the rap scene started fuck with Chris Brown to show that he could rap and shit. Because at this point in 2010, this nigga was rapping his ass off a majority of these tapes and shit. That's why I was so surprised when people realized that this nigga could rap on that Quavo diss song. Because this nigga been rapping since, like, 2010, bro. This nigga been rapping for a long-ass time. He just... I guess people just sleep on that shit. But hey, man, you already know, man. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button, man. If you old here, hit that subscribe button, man. If you think you saw one of my videos before, hit that subscribe button, man. I'm not playing, man. We're going crazy all 2024. And man, as y'all can see, as y'all can smell, as y'all can read, we got Chris motherfucking Breezy, nigga. And we're going to be talking about the motherfucking classic legendary album Fame by Chris Brown, which is aka Forgiving All My Enemies. Some people say it's called Fuck All My Exes, but I highly doubt that shit. But I wouldn't be surprised if that actually was the meaning for that shit. Nah, though, man. Fame by Chris Brown, bro, that dropped in 2011 and shit. Now, many people say this is Chris Brown's best album to this day and shit. This nigga has like 11 albums now. Like, if people still had this on top of their list, I definitely got this definitely on top of my list of all-time favorite Chris Brown albums and shit. This definitely one of the projects by him that you just know you couldn't escape at the time and still can't escape nowadays and shit. But nah, man, y'all already know how these videos go, man. But like I said earlier, if you new here, man, I will explain to you, man. We gonna be talking about Fame by Chris Brown, man. We gonna be these type of videos. I like to just give y'all my opinions and just tell y'all just go deep into the history behind the albums and shit, because they are classic albums and shit. But I like to go ahead and go in depth and go in detail and shit, especially if you never heard this album and shit. So if you watching this and shit, I hope this video at least give you a taste of what this album is, and hopefully you'll like that shit. But we're gonna dare enough talk about majority of the shit that goes behind this album, man. We're gonna talk about before when the album dropped, like, so y'all could get the memo of what he was doing before this shit dropped, and you know, like, the hype and shit that it made, they even made this album even come possible and shit. And then we're gonna talk about, you know, the shit graffiti. We're gonna talk about Kevin McCall, because he's definitely a big part of this album and shit. He definitely a big part of Chris Brown's career from 2010 all the way to like 2013, 2012 and shit. Many people don't really like to give him his credit and shit. He damn near got blackballed, but we're gonna talk about that for another day. So man, before we get into the album Fame, man, we gotta talk about Graffiti, the album by Chris Brown that had dropped right after the Rihanna incident, a couple, but then at the end of the year of 2009 and shit. We gotta talk about this classic right here, because this is a fire ass album by Chris Brown. Definitely one of his most underrated albums for sure. Like, definitely. But this album had a little bit of controversy, because you gotta realize this dropped freshly after the Rihanna shit. So that whole 2009-2010 span of period, we already know Chris Brown was the motherfucking bad guy in people's eyes and shit. So him dropping this album at that time and right after that shit, we should have known that this album was definitely was probably not gonna be a success as I guess he thought it was gonna be. And then it ended up selling low as hell to compare to his first two albums that had dropped a couple years prior and shit. And then this the biggest part about it and shit. Now I know I might be raging just saying it flopped, but is damn near a flop compared to what he was the year prior to it, and I'm gonna explain why. So basically, Chris Brown went into a Walmart and shit. And basically, this nigga ain't see no signs of his album nowhere near it. Cause you know when a new album came out, especially back then and shit, even to this day, but back then, it wasn't really screaming. It was definitely just CDs and shit. So when a new album came out and shit, that shit was down in every store. Best Buy, Target, Walmart, any record store you could think of and shit. All them niggas' albums was in that bitch and shit. So Chris Brown so happened to not see any of his albums and shit on any shelves in that bitch. And that nigga went furious. That nigga got on Twitter and said, they didn't even have my albums in a bag, not on the shelf, saw for myself. I'm tired of this shit, man. Major stores are blackballing my CD. They are not stocking the shelves and lines for customers. What the fuck do I gotta do? I'm not biting my tongue about shit else. The industry could kiss my ass. What the fuck? Yeah, I said it. I ain't retracking shit. We talked to the managers and they didn't even know anything. Wow, but they have my Alicia Keys album ready for release for this Tuesday coming. The managers told me that when there are new releases, it's mandatory to put them on the shelves, but no sign of hashtag graffiti. Bullshit. No disrespect to Alicia at all. Just giving an example to whose album is loaded and ready to go out next week. That nigga Chris Brown was mad as fuck, and I don't blame him and shit. Like, imagine I put all the time into my album and shit, just not to see this shit nowhere. Nigga, I'd be furious too. And that's the reason why the album low-key flopped, because it wasn't a bad side of the album at all. The album was experimental, fire as fuck. Has a dope-ass songs, and the hit I Can Transform You came for that bitch. Hella good songs and shit. It just, at the time, nobody wasn't fucking with this nigga. The whole industry was didn't have their back against this nigga. He was blackballed like a motherfucker and shit. So in my eyes, I felt like he should have already known that. But then again, you gotta realize he's an artist just like everybody else. But niggas was not going for that shit at that time, bro. It was literally fresh after and shit. So Graffiti was dead or like a flop and shit. To his standards, it was a flop. So this nigga Breezy, The next year, 2010 and shit, he'll go on a whole completely different run. I'm talking about when I say run, like a, then like building his career from ground up, like a restart, like a reboot, rebrand type shit. Like, and he'll drop his first ever mixtape in 2010, In My Zone, Rhythm and Screets. It's Chris Brown's first ever mixtape and shit that dropped on live mixtapes hosted by DJ Drama. And man, this shit was a motherfucking classic, nigga. A motherfucking banger, nigga. Like, he just went on a roll with this shit. Like, you gotta realize, like, at this point, Chris Brown wasn't even really rapping. Like, this was, like, Chris Brown was known for his singing and shit. This nigga was showing people on his mixtapes that he was fucking rapping and shit. Like, he was going crazy and shit. And it wasn't bad. Like, it was actually fire. Like, it just lets you know, like, a singing nigga could do anything. That nigga could do anything. Like, that nigga damn near talented anything he goddamn do type shit. He'll just start flooding the whole market with mixtapes and shit. He did an In My Zone 2, Fan of a Fan with Tiger Ass, which was fire as fuck, as classy as hell. He had to damn near rebrand himself, because you gotta realize, nobody wasn't fucking with this nigga at the time, bro. And it's like, the only way you can damn near get back to where you was and shit is rebranding yourself and damn near dropping mixtapes, showing, damn near putting music out and showing niggas that, hey man, like, whether you like it or not, I'm talented at what the fuck I do, nigga. And this was spawning the hit song No Bullshit. Now, it originally was on this mixtape and shit, and it just formed to being on Fame and shit like that. So, like, the majority of 2010, bro, this nigga didn't have to work his way up to the ground up and shit, rebrand his whole self, just start dropping mixtape classic song after song, doing features, hella features and shit, to get himself back to the top and get the whole public to pay attention to his ass again and get them to love his ass and shit. Because, bro, like I said, what if you like it or not, he good at what he do. Him dropping all these mixtapes and shit back to back, it just gave the fans even more hype and shit of what's gonna be next and shit. Cause niggas didn't know at all what was coming and shit. It just, we knew that this nigga was dropping fire ass music and shit, and they'll get the hype for Fame to an all time high and shit. But he will drop, yeah, three times that year, though, in October of that year and shit. And that'll kind of be the first single for Fame and shit, which then it became a classic song and shit. Then it became a hit type shit. Not really a known hit, but like a chart-topping hit type shit. Now, let's talk about Kevin McCall real quick, bro, because we both know that these two was a unstoppable duo around the 2010s and shit, like, literally. Now, some people say that if it wasn't for him being involved in Chris Brown music, his music wouldn't have sounded that good and shit. Some people say since he haven't been involved in Chris Brown music, his music haven't really sounded that good and shit. Now, I faithfully might have to decline, because you gotta realize, after they start working after Fortune, we got X, we got Royalty, we got hella fire good projects for Chris Brown, so I might have to not agree with that take, but I can see what you say by that. Now, I feel like he's a go-to-ass artist and shit. Like, him and Chris Brown collabs and shit, like, on the In My Zones, the Fan for Fans, was fire as fuck. Like, he damn near worked the majority of songs with Chris, like, around the time when nobody wasn't fucking with this nigga, bro. Because Deuces was originally his song and shit, and I think Chris Brown really liked it that much that he damn near gave it to Chris Brown and shit, and Chris Brown, you know, put his little parts in it, you know, shit like that. and it became a hit. And he put Tiger on that bitch, and that shit became a hit. And it's crazy because Deuces was like the comeback song for Chris Brown and shit. Like, that was the song out of all the songs he had dropped on the mixtapes that really took off and shit and became like that hit and shit. Everybody was fucking with No Bullshit and all the other songs, but Deuces was the song that then kind of put Chris Brown back on the map and shit. Now, let me explain. It then was the first song that went number one for him since Say Goodbye, and that shit dropped all the way back in 2005, my nigga. So Chris Brown was cold turkey low key at this point. Not really, but you gotta realize this is right after the Rihanna shit, so niggas went like how blackballed he was at the time and shit. Then when this song dropped, it took that nigga back to the top, like back in conversations, back on TV and shit. So the ball was rolling for Fame. And it's so crazy because Fame was down there originally supposed to be like a double disc album and shit. So this nigga down there been trying to do these 50, 70 song album type, like these long ass type albums way back to 2011, and nigga. So basically what I heard and what I see is that originally he wanted it to be a double disc album consisting of 25 to 30 songs and shit, which I'm guessing he wanted it to be like one side be Fame, and I guess he was gonna do the Fortune. So Fortune was already gonna be like, it then was already an album and shit. So I'm guessing he wanted that to be, and you can say Fortune a sequel, I guess, to Fame, but not really if he kind of made Fortune like a new album and shit. But originally he wanted this to be a double disc album and shit, is what I'm guessing that. So this would have been a long ass album, but the label was like, nah, nigga, cut that shit down to 13 songs, nigga. We don't need that shit. But obviously he had a thing for the long disc song album since way back, because nowadays it's not a Chris Brown album if it don't have fucking 50 songs on that bitch. And it's not even including the deluxe. This is just the main album. And he started really pushing out the singles for this album too, man. Look at me with Chris, with Lil Wayne, the Busta Rhymes and shit. Well, fire as fuck. Like the time, bro, the song was just the most craziest song. Now we all know Busta Rhymes iconic part of shit where he got down rap into his fucking birth run out and shit. Wayne killed this verse too like a motherfucker and shit. I just remember this song being like a big deal at the time, bro. Like the, I remember the Peter Griffin remix version and shit.
Battle check, yellow battle shipping, yellow Lamborghini, yellow chap mission. Yeah, that shit looks like a toupee. I get what you get in 10 years in 2 days.
That been like a big meme and shit on the internet back in the day and shit. I just remember the music video dropped. The music video was so hard, but I low-key still think this top 10 type music videos, bro. Like, it was just so clean, and just for the aesthetic that he was going for with Fame, bro, was just crazy, bro. Beautiful People and shit, which low-key one of my top favorite Chris Brown songs, kind of. It's definitely my top 10 songs from him for sure. Like, this one of those songs that just so positive and shit. It could literally put you in a good mood, bro. Like, you could never be in a bad mood. Listen to this bitch. Like, I really love that song with a fucking passion, my nigga. And I remember when that shit leaked, bro. Like, I remember it leaked, like, late 2010, early 2011 and shit. Like, I think that January and shit. And then it was the same song, just with different lyrics. Like, you could definitely tell it wasn't finished and shit. But I remember when that shit leaked and shit. I remember that bit. I'm telling you about, like, for me being a kid, like the second grade and shit, I was definitely on the internet, bro. Like, I was young as hell on the internet, bro. Like, that shit goes way back with me, bro. I swear to God. And man, bro, Fame, For Giving All My Interviews, dropped on March 18, 2011 and shit. And this shit went absolutely crazy, nigga. This shit debuted at number one on the US Billboard 200. First week sales was 270,000, way more than fucking Graffiti. This shit is triple platinum, my nigga. And man, most of all, this shit got Chris Brown 3 Grammy nominations, and he won his first ever Grammy that night of 2012, and that shit was the album of the fucking year, nigga. Now, many people say, and it's not even really, it ain't really a take, no. This is just facts. Many people say that this album saved Chris Brown's career, and it really did, bro. It put Chris Brown back on the map. It made him, not saying that he just became, like, he definitely still Public Enemy number one to this day, but it made many people fall back in love with him and gave him more fans and shit. Because you gotta realize, bro, and I think many people gotta realize, bro, Chris Brown, like, he's a talented dude, bro. He's gonna forever be talented. He came in the game talented. I'm pretty sure he's gonna leave the game talented as hell. But he's one of the niggas that's talented every day they do type shit. And I feel like people don't give Chris Brown his credit and shit just because the bad shit he got on his name and shit, but we don't even know, man. But man, bro, this album right here, bro, it really did save his career, because you gotta realize, like, Graffiti, they don't doing Graffiti like that at the time and shit. That shit, like, that damn near could have damaged his career. Like, he damn near could have just been one of them niggas that could have flopped with each release and shit. But Chris Brown said, nah, man, I'm too talented for this shit. And he went on a whole spree in 2010, dropping mixtape, banger after banger, until people gave in and gave attention to this nigga. And this nigga ended up dropping a motherfucking banger classic album and shit. Because you can't deny, bro, this album right here is literally Chris Brown's best album. It's not one of his best albums, bro. Like, it just one of the albums for him that just, it's just a fire ass project, bro. Like, nothing was bad about this album, bro. But yeah, man, I really do think this shit saved his career, man. I really do. I feel like this, it's really nothing you can really say that you can backtrack and say it didn't, bro. It really did save his career. Even in interviews, when people ask what's his favorite album, he always kind of chooses this album and shit. He even said that one of his recent interview he did with Tank and them, he basically said how this album low key, that he had to go ground up and shit. He had to rebuild his career ground up, like I said, in 2010 and shit. And he had to, you know, fight and show that courage to show that dog in him that he was that nigga, bro. And he proved to the world and everybody that he's that nigga, whether you like it or not, he's that nigga, bro. And that, ladies and gentlemen, will wrap this video up. If y'all enjoyed this video, man, y'all give this video a big ass thumbs up, man. Look, bro, sentimental times, sentimental fucking times, bro. I love every single one of y'all, bro. This channel is growing every day. Because y'all niggas, man, y'all niggas show hella love to these videos, to this channel. Y'all support all this shit, man. Y'all know I'm never ever, I ain't shit without y'all, bro. Like, that's what I'm gonna say, bro. Because y'all niggas making a young nigga like me just want to go harder and just want to just keep grinding, bro. Just keep putting in work and give me all these videos and shit, because I love the shit I do. Like, I love talking about this shit, man. I love. And it's crazy because some, like, maybe some of y'all don't even really know the albums or know what I'm talking about and shit. And it's crazy that you watch this shit and maybe you could go to their catalog and give whatever album I'm talking about a listen and shit. And I fuck with that because, like, it's damn near like putting people on shit that you damn near been listening to your whole life and shit. And I love to see shit like that. I really do. But, man, like, I try not to make these videos too long and shit. Because these be 20-minute videos and shit, y'all. Like I said, I be having these videos done. It's just like, y'all nigga be editing this shit. It don't take that long for me to edit and shit. Cause it's not like I'm going ballistic with the edits. I just be like to make it look good at least. You know, I don't like to look sloppy sometimes. You know, sometimes I do get lazy. But man, like I say, man, I appreciate every single one of y'all. Loves y'all niggas so much, man. I appreciate all the love and support. I got more shit coming soon, but more tears. Drop in the comments who y'all want to see for the next tier list and shit. I then got an idea for a tier list that I'm then working on, trying to see if I really want to make it to a video. But y'all gonna see though. I might put a little poll on my little on the YouTube community shit, so you might see what I'm talking about. So just drop what y'all want to see in the comments. Any video, any album y'all want to see me talk about. More shit coming soon. Yeah, man. Wow.